This episode was brought to you by Audible. A few days ago, a friend of mine gave me a lovely gift. It's honey, but not any old honey, it is elephant-friendly honey. But honey isn't actually dangerous to elephants, so what does that even mean? Elephant-friendly honey is actually the brainchild of Save the Elephants, who found the perfect solution for farmers in Kenya and elephants. One of the biggest problems farmers face is raiding by elephants. They're able to break through the fences and help themselves to the crops during the night, which of course has a negative impact on the crop's owners if their produce is destroyed. Night raiding puts both the elephants and crop owners at risk, as the elephants are more likely to be shot or injured in an attempt to protect the crops, and the elephants may retaliate aggressively to these attacks. However, it turns out that of all things, elephants were afraid of bees, and Save the Elephants came up with a very neat solution to this problem, beehive fences. Rather than having fences that did nothing to stop the elephants, or electric fences which were expensive to implement and are more likely to cause further damage, they decided to put beehives on adjacent coniferous trees, bordering the fields and connect the beehives together with a wire system. That way, if an elephant were to cross through the beehive fence to raid the field, the movement would disturb the bees who would come out and swarm. The sound of swarming bees is enough to scare off the elephants. They actually send out an infrasonic bee alarm signal and leave the area in search of an easier meal. It is such a beautiful solution. It protects the elephants and the crops in a very easy and cost-effective manner. The coniferous trees the beehives dangle on are environmentally friendly and are very easy to maintain. And as a bonus, the farmers get to produce honey from their beehives, like the pot, which I have here. Perhaps it's the bees who get the slightly less sweeter end of the deal, but I hear they're pretty happy anyway. Who's that?
It's me! I heard humans don't like listening to elephants raiding their crops at night, but they do like listening to audiobooks as they wind down from a long day at work, and I have just the right one for you.
Oh yeah? Which one is it?
It's The Honeybee Democracy by Thomas Seeley. It's all about the work of Seeley and his lab to figure out intricate ways that we have of communicating and voting democratically, longer before you mere human mortals.
And how can I listen to it?
Well, you're in luck. You can go to audible.com/drawcuriosity or text drawcuriosity as one word to 500-500 to get started with a 30-day trial with one free audiobook.
That sounds amazing. Thank you ever so much. But I must go now and get back to wrapping up the episode. And this was Snippet Science, where I deliver science to you in 1 minute or less. You can find out more about this project at elephantsandbees.com and on the charity Save the Elephants. They haven't asked me to make this video, but it was such a neat story that I had to share it. And in case you're wondering what the honey tastes like, all I can say is that it doesn't taste of elephant. And as always, thank you so much for watching me, and I'll see you in the next one.